turn me inside out. Round and round, upside down. Girl, you turn me inside out. And round and round, it's faithlessly give to me the love that I need. I cherish the moment with you. Especially I seem to be, I'm aware that you're cheating, but no one makes them feel like you do.
What's going on, Deacon Richards? How you doing? You listening to In Upside Down by Diana Ross.
I know you got charm and feel, always play the field. I'm crazy to think you are mine. As long as the sun continues to shine, there's a place in my heart for you. Upside down, girl, you turn me inside out. And round and round, upside down, girl, you turn me inside out. Instinctively give to me the love that I need. I cherish my moments with you.
What's going on, Auntie?
Especially I say to thee, I'm aware that you're cheating.
Is that coming out from
me? Upside down.
What's going on, Pastor Jones? What's going on, Sister Elise? I'm listening to Diana Ross, Upside Down. We're going to talk about a little bit about this song.
Girl, you turn me.
That's right, you like that song at least?
Yeah. Around, say upside down.
Away from my part.
Girl, you turn me inside out. Around, say upside down, you're turning me. You give me love instinctively. Round and round, you're turning me. I say to thee respectfully. Upside down, you're turning me. You're giving love instinctively. Around and around, you're turning me. I say to thee respectfully.
Oh, Jesus. Amen, amen.
Amen.
Hey, good evening, everyone. Let's go. Let's go to God in prayer. Father God, Lord, we thank you. Just for another opportunity to come together, Father God, as we pray and we continue to help people who are going through their lives alone, whether they're single, divorced, widowed, or whatever, Father God. We just want to talk about some things that's real, Father God, realistic, and give them realistic ways to get out of current bad situations and bad relationships. In Jesus' name, amen.
Amen.
Good evening. What's going on, Sister Mary? You missed my singing. You came on late on purpose.
She did.
So this just some house cleaning. This Sunday, we weren't able to get the park. We will be at the Holiday Inn this Sunday. We will be recognizing two of our graduates, two of our high school graduates who are connected with us. We will recognize them on this Sunday. High school graduates, praise God, for Brother Jalen and who else we got?
Nicholas.
Brother Jalen and Brother Nicholas. So we will be recognizing them on Sunday. So praise God. So come on out. God has a word. Yeah. We will continue on our series, Sunday morning, Understanding the Journey of the Church, or Understanding the Church. We're just going to be talking about the church and some things like that. We got some great things coming up in June. We'll give you more information in June. We're going to have three services in a row, third and fourth Sunday and first Sunday. We'll talk about that this Sunday. But today, I was listening. We want to talk about, we've been going through this journey dealing with singles or people who are living alone, how to journey through living alone. We dealt with some different things over the last couple of weeks. One of the reasons I played this song, this is a very popular song by Diana Ross, Upside Down. And growing up as a kid, listening to this song, man, I didn't know no clue what this song meant. I listened to this song over and over. But a couple of years ago, I actually happened to listen to the words of the song. And basically, the song is about a woman who's in love with a man who ain't no good. He's a cheater. It's a bad relationship. Right. Bottom line is, it's not a good relationship. And anytime you are in a relationship where you love that person, they don't love you back, or if it's an abusive situation, or whatever the situation is, some relationships are not good to be in. And some relationships, not only they're not good, they can actually become toxic. Mm-hmm. And what we want to talk about tonight, I'm going to put up some scriptures on how not to get yourself caught up in toxic relationships, and what toxic relationships, we're going to try to talk about what toxic relationships look like, and then the need to get out of them.
Yeah.
Because the reality is, there are some relationships we have no business being in. And you know what? And you may not be single. You may be watching this, you may be married. Mm-hmm. You could be in a toxic marriage. And the reality, I'm not at all promoting divorce. But there are some marriages that just need to dissolve. Bottom line. That's just the reality of it. You know, you might say, well, that's not a lack of faith or whatever. Listen, let me tell you something. There are some relationships, if it's destroying you emotionally, physically, and spiritually, you need to get out of it, whether you're married or not. If those things are destroying you, those three things on those three levels are destroying you, and there's no... We're not talking about personality issues. We're not talking about, you know, I like blue, you like black, or stuff like that. We're not talking about those disagreements or whatever. We're talking about relationships that are, we're talking about Bobby Brown, Whitney type of stuff. Mike Tyson, Robin Givens type of stuff. You know, those type of relationships. When a relationship is just bad and you're spiraling downhill, and the relationship is getting you further and further away from the kingdom and Christ. Because any relationship that the only reason you're connecting with God in your relationship because you're praying, because you're in a bad relationship, that's a problem. Mm-hmm. That's a problem. That the only time you're turning back to God, and you can't change people. So let's get to it. Okay. And I would love your feedback. I would love your feedback and your comments.
Yeah, please
also.
Comment.
Yeah. First, I want to go to getting in bad relationships. How do we get there? How do we get in there?
Mm-hmm.
1 Corinthians chapter 6, this is a rare, people read this scripture all the time, especially when they deal with marriage. I just look at it from relationship, period.
Okay.
And 1 Corinthians chapter 6 says, verse 14, do not be unequally yoked together with unbelievers. For what fellowship has righteousness with lawlessness, and what communion has light with darkness?
Mm-hmm.
Let's talk about this unequally yoked. Yoked. The word yoked, unequally yoked. So a yoke is a wooden cross beam that they put on two animals and they plow.
Mm-hmm.
The purpose of the yoke being equal is for the animals to pull a straight line. Okay? If the yoke is uneven and one ox is stronger than the other, or even the beam is not made correctly, what happened is the oxen, they will zigzag and make crooked lines. It won't be straight. Right. So in other words, the yoke is supposed to make them work together. And you should have two animals of equal. So you can't put an oxen on one part of the yoke and put a donkey on one, because the oxen is stronger. It's not going to work.
Right.
And in relationships, a lot of time in relationships, they become toxic. You're heading in the direction of a toxic relationship. Because you're not equally yoked. Not necessarily just spiritually, but you're not on the same page financially. You're not on the same page educationally. Yeah. You're definitely not on the same page from an emotional standpoint. And many times we think we can bring people to where we are. I call it making people a project. You try to build them up where you are.
Right.
And the reality is, you really need to be dating people or seeing people that got the same vision as you. The same dream, some similarities. What do you think?
I agree. You can't be with someone if he's going or she's going this way and you're going that way, because you'll never get to where you need to be. So absolutely, you have to be yoked up equally.
But the question is, what makes people want to connect with people who have nothing in common with them? What is the basis sometimes?
I think it's our flesh, to be honest, mm-hmm. because, you know, they say men are visual, and sometimes women are visual too. And so if you see someone that you like, you know, physically, that you're attracted to, you make them a project and you do whatever you can to try to make it work. But that's how we get in bad situations. I think it's all our flesh.
Yeah. And you know, when we talk about that flesh and unequal yoke, one of the stories that really brings the light in the Bible is Samson and Delilah. Mm-hmm. Samson was supposed to be a gift to God. You know, he was born, his mother prayed, he got Samson. God had specific instructions. He's not supposed to drink any wine. He wasn't supposed to be around anything dead. But Samson had some issues with his flesh. And he had issues with his flesh and got in relationships that were toxic. Mm-hmm. Which caused him to kill people and act a fool. And sometimes toxic relationships, when you're in a bad relationship with somebody, it can cause you to act out of your character or what God created you to be. Mm-hmm. And then what ended up happening, he ended up getting with Delilah. And man, and if you don't know the story, Delilah, and here's the thing, when you read the story in Judges, it's in Judges, I believe Judges 13. When you read the story of Samson and Delilah, mm-hmm. even when she was asking him, hey, you know, where he gets his strength from, he was lying.
Yeah.
And if you're in a relationship where you got to lie to somebody, you know what I'm saying? Because you don't want people to get close to you or whatever. You got to lie and you can't be truthful. So that whole relationship was like
a mess.
A mess. And then eventually, you know, he fell asleep. And
How he fell asleep?
I don't know how he fell. She put him to sleep.
She put him to sleep, y'all.
She put him to sleep. So we're going to be honest here tonight.
Yeah, we're going to be honest.
What's up, Pastor David? So she put him to sleep.
Yeah.
That's some good sleep. And next thing you know, he's bound. And then they end up cutting his hair. And then he's in a bad situation. They pluck his eyes out.
Yeah, he got set up.
And he got set up. And he leads him to this point. Destruction took place after that. And that's how sometimes toxic relationships, you end up getting, because your flesh overcomes what your spiritual and what your mind tells you to do. In other words, you say, hey, this person may not go to church. This person may not be saved. Okay, they may not have the best job, but, you know, they look good. They smell good.
Making you feel good.
Yeah, they're making you feel good. We can make this work.
No, you're trying to make it work. Because most of the times, if it's toxic, it's only one person trying to make it work. Because they already know what they can do to you because you have no standards.
Right.
So if they're lying to you, cheating on you, beating you, you know, anything, they already know what they can do to you.
Right. So yeah, it's just one of those things you have to be careful that you're connecting with people who are not on the same path as you. I know, and here's the reality, and I'm going to talk about this in a second. You have to be careful because you can't, light does not go with darkness. Eventually, one is going to overcome the other. Mm-hmm. You know, you may say, I'm going to let my light shine around dark people, but also I find out sometimes light bulbs go out.
It's true.
And then here's the thing. Oh, this is good. And if you're not connected to the power source, which is Jesus, and the person gets you, you're going to lose your light, and your light's going to continue to shine. Because what happens is one part of the reason we're in toxic relationships, especially when you're saved. And we're talking about Christians now. We're not talking about just people who aren't saved. We're talking about there are Christian men and women who are in toxic relationships.
Yeah.
We're not talking about folk in the world. We're talking about folk who say they know Jesus, folk go to church every Sunday, sing in our choirs, preach in our pulpits, operate in ministries, and they are in bad relationships. You're like, man, why are you in this thing? And they want you to pray for them. They want you to cover them. They trying to get counseling for a relationship that's going nowhere.
Right.
Because they went in there unequally yoked. You can't expect if a person has never... Like, one of the things I tell people when it comes to do work, like work and money and finances,
mm-hmm.
I always ask in relationships that you want to find out what is their work history.
Yeah.
A lot of people don't ask about that, man. You're like, what that got to do with anything? Because if they always quitting a job, if they got like, if they're 21 years old, no, I say 30 years old, and they have no consistency where they stayed at a job, and I'm not talking about getting job promotions or stuff like that. We talking about just minimal job.
I don't like this job.
They treat me bad. They're probably going to have that going. They're not going to have a job.
Yeah.
And so you have to really, think about that, because if that can become a toxic relationship, because what will happen is either they're going to use you financially,
mm-hmm.
or you're going to turn into the abuser because they don't have the finances. And then it just is a spiraling thing. And next thing you know, you're not happy and you're not. So that's the one thing. Make sure you're on the same page. Can I also be honest with you? Is that also being unequally yoked? Make sure if you have a desire to get married, make sure the person you meet has that same desire. You know, if that person say, hey, I'm not, I was watching something on TV. It was one of them shows. And and the guy was like, you know, he told the woman, hey, I'm not interested in just dating. I'm looking for somebody special. I don't know if he was playing or he was for real, but that's how you have to be honest in the relationship. If you, because if you come to a person and you, oh, I really like them, and they tell you they don't want to get married, then you're going to find yourself unsatisfied and unhappy because they don't want to settle down. And you're expecting them to be faithful. You're expecting all these things from a person that don't want to get married. Because usually when you get married, that means faithfulness. So what other reason I don't want to get married? So sometimes you got to kind of think about that. Why are you so adamant about not getting married? If we're together, we're living together, or we're seeing each other every day, what's the problem? Because they told you from day one they didn't want to do that. And then now you're arguing all the time. You're unhappy. You're unsatisfied. Then you wonder why this person's out all the time. Because guess what? There's no accountability there. So next thing I want to go to is Proverbs 13, verse 20. And let me just see how you feel about this. Matthew 13, verse 20 says, he who walks with wise men will be wise, but the companion of fools will be destroyed.
Yeah.
Not the person that's the fool going to be destroyed.
The fool going to destroy you.
The companion of a fool will be destroyed. When I look in this text and I counsel certain people in different toxic relationships with people who are abusive verbally, physically, those who are in connected relationships with people who are on drugs, people who are in relationship with people that don't want to work. And I agree with you that friendship is the first step because, sister Elise, because friendship, when you have a great friendship, you have a better connection of knowing who this person really is before you go into a relationship. And I think that's very important that even in your, you could be friends with people, you know, unequally yoked, but you're not living with them. You're not trying to get connected with them where in the relationship is a totally different bond. And I think friendship will get you on that course. But being a companion of fools, people who are just foolish out here just doing whatever, what happens is it destroys you. Rudy?
I think so, because you said earlier it'll bring you out of your character. So it'll have you busting people windows out and acting a fool all in public and driving by people's house and hiding in bushes and all kind of crazy stuff.
Yeah.
It will destroy you. And I just don't have time, you know, to be chasing somebody, you know, in my old age. Chasing somebody, trying to figure out what he is and who they talking to and all that. It will literally destroy, you know, your mind.
Yeah, and I think also what it does is when being connected with a fool or person will destroy you is that a lot of times this person will get you away from the church.
Mm, absolutely.
It'll get you from your spiritual, because they're not going to church. Oh, and I see this, as a pastor, I've seen this so many times, y'all. So many times where young ladies who were active or faithful or young men who were active and faithful in the church, they get in a relationship and I don't see them no more. Mm-mm. They laying up in the bed happy. You know, posting on Facebook at 11 o'clock in the morning. On Sunday morning, posting on Facebook, taking pictures. They in the park somewhere. They supposed to be at church. And I ain't telling nobody, Billy. Y'all be putting that on Facebook y'all selves. It's crazy.
That's true.
It's crazy. I'm like, man, you supposed to be at church.
Yeah, you prayed for a man. Now you got a man. Yeah. Nobody see you.
You know, you got married or whatever. And nobody. And it'll draw. Sometimes some people will draw you away. And you think it's about being happy. You think you're excited.
Yeah.
But people who are not connected with God and the devil has a way of pulling you away from Jesus. And a lot of time that's in relationships. Yeah. Also what happens, look, Pastor David said that's true. He probably got the same issue. I think all the pastors got the same issue. Other thing that's true is that Whitney and Bobby. Let's talk about Whitney and Bobby, for example. Whitney and Bobby Houston. Bobby Brown.
Right,
he might well be Houston. But
Don't talk about Bobby.
They were codependent drug addicts.
Mm-hmm.
It was said and believed that Whitney was on cocaine and dragged Bobby Brown into that.
Mm-hmm.
You know, at first everybody thought Bobby was getting her into it.
Yeah.
And what happens a lot of times, being in relationships that are toxic where there's a drug addict can make both of y'all codependents.
Mm-hmm.
And they can drag you into that world. When you do, because it's foolish to do drugs, marijuana, cocaine. That's foolish. All of them, yeah. All of them. But it is so easy when you're hanging with them or you're connected in a relationship, they'll drag you into that. Yeah. And you're hanging with them, but guess what? They're still doing drugs. They're still good, but it's destroying your life. It's destroying your life. Because a lot of times in toxic relationship, only one person come out the loser.
Yeah. You know, I don't know about the drug thing. It just depends on how strong you are. Because that goes back to your morals and your lines, where you cross the line. But even if one person is on drugs, both people still lose. Because if you're with someone and they're on drugs and they're taking your money out the house, mm-hmm. spending it on drugs or... you know, causing emotional strain because you don't know where they are. I mean, that's losing too.
Yeah, but it depends. That's what I'm saying. But I'm thinking about the person who's already on drugs. They on drugs. They live in the street. They good. Oh, let me be clear. Them drug addicts, them crackheads, they been lifelong crackheads. And they good. They can live in a... But you have been working hard. You got this great job. Yeah. And now this person that got you drawn in.
Yeah.
And now it's destroying your life. Because guess what? When the breakup happens, finally, they'll go back, continue doing drugs and doing whatever. But now you got to try to repair. I done seen so many times where people, I got to catch up. I got to repair my relationship with my children that I have. Now I got to try to go back to church and face these church folk or whatever, trying to get back in good graces with God.
Yeah.
Because when you deal with people who are not connected with God in a relationship and you hang out with fools, people who are abusive or whatever, it says you will the companion will be destroyed. Mm-hmm. Hanging out with toxic people and staying in bad relationships will destroy your life. Mm-hmm. It will destroy your life. And anyone that doesn't believe who God is, anybody who's not connected with God, we have to be careful. And when I mean connected with God, because they could be say they saved and have no connection with the Holy Spirit and with God. Because I think when you're connected with the Holy Spirit, it will compel you to behave in certain ways. Not saying we're perfect. Right. Not saying we're not going to make mistakes. But there should not be a habitual habit of abuse and toxicity in the relationship.
Right.
And many now, one of the things, so make sure you hang who you're hanging with. But the companion of fools will be destroyed. Mm-hmm. And I've seen so many people's lives broken because of drugs. Then here's the other problem. You hook up with somebody who's on drugs and you try to fix it or whatever, you might end up on it. And then now you got an addiction. Or you get in a relationship where this person's constantly cheating on you. I like that. Some people use God to get close to you. Yeah. And that is true.
Yeah.
Some people act like they say and filled with the Holy Ghost just to get to you. And then next thing you know, you figured out that they pull off that sheep hat.
Yeah, well, I said the representative that they sent.
The representative. Yeah. But here's the thing. But just because they may have tricked you of going in, once you find out, you ain't got to stay in there. Because the one thing the Bible says is try the spirit by the spirit. And that's why what you said earlier, Elise, about friendships, I believe in the long courtship. A lot of people don't believe what I believe. I've always believed in this. And people say I was a hater, you wrong with the pastor. I don't care. I believe in long courtships. I don't believe I met you on Monday, we should get married on Friday. I'm like, I met you on Monday in 2020. What is it, 2021? So I met you on May 2021. I may ask you to marry me in January of 2022, but we may not get married to 2023, 2024. I personally believe in a 3 to 4 year courtship. And this would let me paint the picture with this courtship. I also believe in that courtship. You should never cohabitate. Some people call it shacking or whatever you want to call it. I think you should not even cohabitate. I think me and Ronica, we dated how long before we got married? We met January 2005. And then we got married October 2008. So that's about 3.5 years. I'm close to 4 years. But we didn't cohabitate. I didn't even have a key to her house. And she didn't have a key to my house. Because I didn't believe in those type of relationships. Yeah. Because what happens is when you start cohabitating, and especially if the relationship turns toxic, it makes it more difficult to get out. We're talking about single people. We're not talking about married people. Once you bring your stuff together, it makes it harder
to separate.
So when you're in a toxic relationship with somebody and the relationship's going bad, this person's cheating or this person's abusive or just arguing about dumb stuff every day, and it's taking you away from God's presence. Mm. That's the key. That's when you know it's toxic, when you don't even recognize who you are and you can't even recognize if Jesus is in the situation. And that's a big thing. When you can't, that's when you gotta reevaluate your relationship. Is God in this? And have and that's an honest answer. Because mm-hmm. how hard it is to say when you're in love, to say God is not in this.
Well, when you're in love, you probably ain't thinking about God.
That's true. Yeah, when you're in love, you ain't thinking
about God. You ain't thinking about God when you're in love.
Yeah, you want to think about God when they're putting you to sleep.
Oh my goodness.
Thank you. That's what you were saying.
I just say, to me, I feel like, you know, saved or unsaved, if you love someone and they don't love you back the same way, then you may be in a toxic relationship. It don't mean, you know, that they're not saved or they're the devil or anything, but you can be together and just not be for each other.
Right.
Because I've loved people who didn't love me back in the same way.
Because right. good people could be in a toxic relationship. Both of y'all could be good people. It's just that relationship ain't working. Y'all not good together.
Yeah.
Yeah, that's a good one, too. Y'all both could be saved. We're both saved. Well, y'all not good together. Some people just need to break up. Listen, like I said, some people, like, dude, y'all, what? Yeah, and you know, some people are better co-parents than they are being in a relationship.
Right. Yeah.
It just don't work. Some relationships don't work. Don't mean both of them are bad people, but usually what happens is if you put your tart and earn part in a relationship that's going nowhere, you will be destroyed. How do I kind of get out of this thing? How do I get out of this thing? One of the things I want to bring up is Psalms 139. Because I think many of us stay in these long-term relationships for a couple of reasons. If I go, one of the reasons is investment. We feel, it's almost like the stock market. And we treat our relationships like the stock market.
Yeah.
In the stock market, people tell you, even when the stock is going bad, don't touch it.
Yeah.
Leave it alone. Mm-hmm. Quit putting your relationships like that. And I think we do our relationships the same way. We think that we invested so much time and energy that it may change. Maybe if I stick it out, it'll change. Because you've invested so much. Or you have this mentality is, I don't want to invest so much in a relationship. And then they end up being with somebody else. And that person reap the benefits of what I did. You ain't do nothing. You didn't do nothing.
Some people think they did.
Well, you didn't do nothing. It's just what it was. That person was supposed to be with that other person. And a lot of times, man, if you catch somebody, especially in a cheating relationship, if you catch somebody cheating, let the other person have them. Sometimes in life, you got to take the L.
Oh, absolutely.
Sometimes you got to celebrate when somebody took your man or your woman from you.
Yeah, you got to lose.
Sometimes you got to lose.
Fantasia said you got to lose win again.
Sometimes you got to let them stocks go.
Yeah.
Look, stop sharing your stocks. Yeah. Yeah, let it go. Yeah. Let them shot sell. You know what? You good, because here's the thing. So what? They go off and get with somebody and they prosper or whatever. And that's based on your perception of what you see.
Yeah.
You know, that's based on your perception of what you see. But the reality is sometimes it's better to be broke. I've learned in life that it was better for me to be broke than to be in certain relationships. Mm-hmm. It was better for me to be homeless. Amen? It was better for me to be homeless to be in a certain relationship. Because God knows how to restore that. And I think from a woman's perspective, why do you think women hang on to bad relationships?
I think for a few reasons. I think one reason is because of love. I think women love hard, and it is the investment thing. I put, you know, a woman can be with a man for 15 years, and he won't marry her, and they break up, and 6 months later, he married somebody else already. But you wouldn't marry the person that invested all the time in you. So sometimes it's for love. Sometimes women just don't know their value, I think. And they don't recognize when someone, you have to be honest, when someone don't love you the way that you love them. If you're not reciprocating what I'm giving you, then that's toxic all in itself. Because in the end, you're going to be hurt.
Right.
So I just think, you know, women need to learn how to recognize when you're not getting what you're giving, mm-hmm. and walk away. Mm-hmm. But it's so hard to walk away because we are so invested.
Right. Now with men, now I'm gonna be open and I'm gonna be as real as possible. Why do men stay in bad relationship with y'all call crazy women? Why? And men do it too, y'all. We stay in them relationship with them girl. They crazy is all out. Couple of reasons. One, crazy women are fire. Ooh, they fire. We love that. For whatever reason, some men actually like that. They like
one. You like crazy girls.
They, boy, look. Yeah. We were talking about earlier, talking about how Delilah put Samson to sleep. Crazy girls put you to sleep. And what happens, yes, so what happens is it becomes more about a flesh thing.
Yeah, absolutely.
Where, hey, crazy girls got it going on. Crazy girls that'll cut you and all that, boy. And that's how some men think. It's hard to let go of a woman. And you be thinking, well, all women, it's no, you know, now, don't get me wrong, you get the same results, but, man, it's just something about a crazy woman, man.
I'm that, so done.
All that, look, that passion she used in slashing your tires, breaking your window, she bring that to the bed, she bring all that. Oh, and a lot of men don't know how to let that go. Okay. You be surprised. Then it's not that they love her, but a lot of men are so connected to that sexual part of the relationship that is hard to let go. And you be like, who? Especially, you know, like, yeah.
Break your window down.
Yeah, break your window. Yeah, that's the girl. That's my girl. You know?
Get your windows fixed.
The other reason why we stay in toxic relationships is because of Larry Pastor Dave said triple X.
Oh, Jesus.
Yeah, Pastor Dave. But the other problem is that men are selfish and we're possessive. We're very possessive. So what happens is a lot of times we don't want to be with her, but we don't want nobody else to have her. And it's not even got to do with the fact that she loves us. It ain't got to do with the fact that, ooh, I love it, that Jezebel spirit. Mm-hmm. It has nothing to do with the fact she takes care of our thing. But the reality is we don't want nobody else to have sex with her. Mm. So we'll stay in a bad relationship. And she might be cheating or she might be doing, we'll stay in a relationship because we don't want nobody else to have, because we become, and I'm just being honest, fellas. Y'all, yeah, let's just be honest. Because we become possessive. Because in our mind, we can't see her sleeping with somebody. We can't, it ain't that we see her being better with somebody else. It ain't see her seeing that she's marrying somebody else, got a nice house. We don't see that. All we see is we don't want her doing to him what she do to us. So what she did with us. So what we'll do is we'll try to stay in that situation. And we'll be miserable because it's all about sex. Wow. And we'll perpetrate, oh, I don't want you to leave because of the kids. I don't want you to leave because I love you. But the reality, a lot of times, and what happens is, then we also lose, men at the same time, we lose our value in ourselves. Mm. We lose our value in ourselves that, hey, you know what, I'm not going to find a woman like her. I'm not going to find a woman because we're shallow. That's another thing. Men, we are very shallow. We find ourselves in toxic relationships because we are very shallow. I'm just being honest with it.
Yeah.
Sometimes we can be very shallow that she got to have a long, this, I ain't going to find another girl with the long hair and the pretty face and all that. But one thing I'm going to tell you, every brother, and I, if you're watching, everything that look good ain't good for you. Mm-mm. I don't care how fine, I done met some of the finest ones and guess what? They were crazy. And I left them alone. Run. What the Bible say? Flee from evil.
Flee.
Run, Joe. Run. You got to run from it. And that's why I want to go to this next scripture, what you were talking about, Psalms 139. I love this. Psalms 139, verse 14. I will praise you, for I am fearfully and wonderfully made. Marvelous are your works, and that my soul knows very well. I praise you, for I am fearfully and wonderful. What does that mean? I am fearfully. You got to know that you're fearfully and wonderfully made. Fearfully. What does that mean? God did not create you from a, when we say fear, like we're scared. Mm-hmm. When we say fearfully, that means we're made respectfully.
Yeah.
It means that God made you out of respect. And you should never be in a relationship where you're being disrespected.
I agree.
Because I wasn't created to be disrespected. What do you think about, like...
Yeah, I think with, you know, women, we tolerate. I think when you get in a relationship, somebody will try you. And then you take that. Then they'll try to push it a little further. Before you know it, you're knee deep in. And we were, you know, created to be respected, but when you're in love, you tend to tolerate some things that maybe you shouldn't.
Right.
So I think it just starts little by little. Oh, she let me get away with that. Okay, well, I'll try this. Well, you know, she let me get away with that. And then, you know, before you know it, you like, God, how did I get here?
Right. Yeah. And you, what's going on, Sister Mel, my cousin Melanie? You got to respect yourself.
Yeah.
You know, there has to be a level of respect. And when people get in a relationship where the levels of disrespect is beyond, because you don't, you have to demand people to talk to you a certain way in a relationship.
Yeah.
Up front. You know, this is not what you're going to say to me. This is not how you're going to talk to me. You're right. So learn how to love yourself and look for those signs.
Yeah. And then if you start overlooking stuff, that's how you get too far gone.
Because what happened is, I think, like, with men, we lose our value. Because I'm going to tell y'all, man, ladies, I know we do some stuff, but y'all are very slick with the mouth. Let's be clear. Now, women are y'all can be very disrespectful with the mouth. And as men, I'm going to be honest with you, we don't have to take that. You do not have to take that because, yeah, you know, that's just a woman or whatever. But you ain't, because here's the thing. If we're teaching men not to put their hands on women, mm-hmm. then we need to teach women not to verbally abuse their husbands or men. Because y'all could be mad. Let me tell you something. Y'all start rolling that head and stuff. and y'all go from 0 to 60. When y'all gone, Lord. But, and vice versa. I think you got to demand a level. When you going in a relationship, you have to demand a level of respect. That, hey, if you're going to be with me, this is how I'm going to be treated.
Absolutely.
Point blank. And if you cannot treat me like this, then we can't be in a relationship. And I think a lot of times you said, we let, well, somebody said, yes, tame the tongue. Mm-hmm. the next snap, yeah. Yeah, so y'all go that, boy. Y'all go to zero. What y'all say? One more. What is it?
What?
How y'all say when y'all get ready to get started? What you say? Yeah. First of all. That's what
first
it is.
First of all.
First of all.
Yeah, just walk away.
You know, when sister say first of all, man, deuces. But, and you're wonderfully made. Value. You know, there's nothing wrong. It's not conceited to value yourself. Mm-hmm. That is not conceit, y'all. It's confidence. There's a difference between confidence and conceited. There's nothing wrong with saying, hey, listen, I ain't got to put up with that because I'm cute. There's nothing wrong with saying that. Look, I'm telling you. I look good. I'm a dark young man. I look good. I got good hair. I do not have to put up with this.
I knew the good hair was coming.
That's my go-to. So when I get old, I got to go with my gold hair. I'm old and got, but I got good hat on. I ain't got no teeth. But the reality is you got to be able to tell people that. And it's not being conceited telling folks, hey, listen, I'm too good to put up with this.
I know, that's right.
I'm not putting up with this. There are other people that want me. There are other people that value me. And you have to understand that about yourself. When people know that you value yourself, mm-hmm. they're not going to come at you any kind of way. Because they know if I don't do right, this person can be with somebody else. And guess what? Even if I don't find somebody else, I'm cool with me.
Amen.
Because if I'm not going to allow you to disrespect me, and because I'm made with value. I'm God's creation.
Yeah.
I'm God's creation. And once you know you're God's creation, God has a person. So there are certain things as a man or woman of God you don't have to put up with. You don't have to put up with.
Yeah.
Now, let me ask you this. Because this is going to be a big one. I really love y'all feedback on this one. Whether people are married, because I'm going into the marriage thing also, or even relationships. How do you feel when church folk, pastors, or spiritual leaders tell people to stay in toxic relationships? They don't really understand the whole nature, because, you know, people don't always share everything. Right. But how do you feel about, because this happens in the church where we try to preach and teach people and stand in the bad relationships.
Yeah, and it's not just in the church. I find it with, I remember my grandma used to say, beat him up and stay with him. You know, if you find your man cheating, beat him up, but you stay with him. And to me, that's just foolishness. And I have seen pastors tell people to stay married. Well, you shouldn't have got married. You know, now you in there, try to pray. But sometimes prayer don't change the other person.
Right.
So you got to pray for yourself. Lord, give me strength enough to walk mm-hmm. away. And I try not to tell people to stay with nobody. If you tell me that God is leading you to move on, then I'm supporting you in that decision. I'd never be the pastor to tell somebody to stay. Because like you said, people don't tell you everything. They right. tell you what they want you to know. Because some stuff is just embarrassing.
And some, yeah, thank you. And something else can be worse than in situations. And then also, here's a scripture I want us to stop using. I'm going to help y'all today. We're going to teach today, y'all. This is something I want y'all to stop using. When people come to you and my marriage is bad or somebody cheated or whatever. One of the scriptures I think is used irresponsibly is the story of Hosea. Mm. You're right, Sister Walker. No one really knows what's going on behind closed doors. So I can tell you, you should stay. God wants you to be together. And then next thing you know, somebody's dead.
Yeah.
That's why as a pastor, I never tell people to stay or go. I may ask, hey, can y'all work it out? Or, you know, what can I do to help you? I might do something like that. Yeah. But the reality, I never tell people to stay and I never tell people to go. Now, have I told people to get out of certain situations because it was that I didn't know it behind the closed doors? Yes. But, and sometimes the pastor's in a toxic relationship, right?
He don't even know.
But one of the scriptures I think is irresponsibly used, and I think we should stop using this as a reference when people break up or in toxic relationship, is the story between Hosea and Gomer. If you don't know the story about Hosea and Gomer, Hosea was a prophet and he was married to a prostitute. Mm-hmm. And God asked him or told him, commanded him to marry this prostitute. She went out, she cheated, she was a prostitute. He had to go buy her back because God wanted to use Hosea as an example between the relationship between him and the children of Israel. Okay. Here's the key thing about that. I hear people use that where if Hosea took his wife back or he took her back and she was a prostitute, you should be able to take this person back. Mm-hmm. Here's a problem that I have with that. God specifically told Hosea, he heard the voice of God, to go take this woman back.
Right.
Here's my thing. If you ain't heard the voice of God directly yeah. to take somebody back or stay in a toxic relationship, you need to leave. Yeah. We need that. If you're going to teach that Hosea and Gomer, you have to teach it from a full understanding. God directly talked to Hosea. And then also it was a purpose on why he had Hosea do that. So in other words, Hosea was making a major sacrifice to be a vessel for God for that season. So we cannot use that as a reference for people to stay in toxic relationship, people who are habitually cheating and having people keep taking back. Because here's the thing. Even if you're not putting hands on people, verbally abusing, cheating is a form of abuse.
Yeah.
Habitual cheating is a form of abuse, period. So that's right. The voice of God. That's my cousin, Tamisha. Yeah, that's right. You got it.
That's right.
Especially if you don't know about soul ties and all that. So the reality is, if God is not speaking to you to stay on the Holy Spirit, because we have the Holy Spirit now, and it's not leading you to stay in that, get out of that situation. Yeah. And a lot of times, I think many of us are staying in relationships waiting on God, and God has already given you the tools and the strength to leave yourself. Mm. Because here's the thing. You were doing good before you met that person.
Yeah. Or if you let that person draw you from God, you can't hear his voice because you're so focused on that person that you done let them disconnect you from your source.
Right.
So,
and here's the thing. And here's another thing, and we're almost done. If you find yourself scrolling through your significant other's phone, let's be honest. If you find yourself scrolling through their phone and all their social media stuff, seeing what they're doing on social media more than you reading this, you, my friend, are in a toxic relationship. Because many times that we'll do that. Scroll, look through phones, look through all that stuff. I see what they doing, looking at letters, and don't even open the Word of God. Mm-hmm. If your focus is more, even in marriage, I love my wife. Don't get me wrong. I love my wife dearly. We have a great relationship, great marriage. But I can't focus more on her than Jesus. Even if when we're not, like, we're not on one accord, we can't focus on, I can't be worrying about what Ronica's doing, what she's doing. I don't go through phones. We don't have passwords. And all, like, that's another thing. We don't have, in a relationship, like, she knows my password. My password is for other people, not to go on my phone. But my wife has my password. When I leave the table, I leave my phone at my home. I have to take my phone to the, look, I don't have to take my phone to the bathroom and all that. Because if you can't even be open like that and be free, and you got to have passwords and all that, or you got to be in people's stuff. Because one thing I do believe is that whatever's in the dark will come to the light. So yep. You don't have to...
When
you
tell every woman that it'll fall right in your lap. You don't have to do that.
If you use that same energy of investigation...
Investigation?
The spirit of investigation.
Okay.
If you can use that same spirit of investigation to use that spirit to investigate the word of God, I promise you, if you use that same energy, that same looking up knowledge, how to find stuff on Google, see who he talking to. If you can do that with the Bible, man, and put that in your life, it'll change your life and transform your life. And it'll open your eyes to either make that relationship better or help you lead that relationship.
That's right.
Because I think what happens is that we have to stop focusing on each other. Mm-hmm. And start focusing on God, and God will get us right. So what would you tell people out here if they're currently in bad relationship, toxic relationship? They so far connected with God. Can they still get connected with God? Can they still
Absolutely.
Come back? God take them back.
God take anybody back.
God will take.
God never let you go. You let Him go. Mm. Now, that's the thing. People saying, you know, will God take me back? He never left you. You left Him for somebody else. So, yeah, He'll take you back. You know, like I said, I don't tell people to break up. I don't tell them to stay together. I let them make their own decision.
Right.
If, you know, one of my friends confided in me, you know, my husband cheated on me. What should I do? I said, what do you want to do? If you want to leave, I'm going to support you in that. If you want to stay, I'm going to support you in that.
Right.
So I try to, you know, stay out of folks' business. But he said, amen first.
Yes, and I know it's difficult when you're in a relationship, the bad relationship. Ladies, y'all, that's right, at least y'all cheat too. You know?
No, she told me we cheat on God. God.
Oh, okay, she's talking about God. Okay, yeah. I'm sorry, my bad. I took that personally. Y'all cheat too.
Yeah. Anybody can cheat, but you know, like I said, you know.
And no judgment here. If you are in a relationship, and I just want to close with you. If you are in a relationship, bad or good, whether you live together, cohabitate or not, I'm not here to judge. I'm here to help. I just pray that make sure that whatever relationship you're in, you choose yourself and God first.
Yeah.
However, you know, if that's what you choose to do, I love you regardless. We love you regardless, man. God loves you regardless. But we want to make sure that you're making the right decision for yourself, for your spirit, for your emotional well-being.
Ooh, yeah.
We don't want you to ever be in a situation where you wasted time in a bad relationship. And now you're 60, 70 years old. And you're looking back on your life and like, man, I could have been happy a long time ago.
Yeah. Don't waste your youth.
Yeah.
On some fool that didn't want you in the first place, and then you find yourself living regret.
Right.
But I think it's important to let people know that we've all played the fool.
Yes.
You know, it's a song, you know, everybody played. Everybody done played.
I should have sung that, Mary.
At one point, and I think some people are so ashamed because they think it's just them. It's not just you. I done been a fool. I mean, everybody done been a fool. And if they tell you they haven't, they lie.
I've been a fool, unsaved and saved. I was a fool on the unsaved side, and I played the fool after I was saved.
And it has nothing to do with you. Because some people have that, you know, he found somebody prettier than me, she got more than me. It doesn't even matter. What you say, Halle Berry got cheated on?
She could even Halle Berry got cheated on.
She's the most beautiful woman in the
matter
world.
Matter of fact, Jennifer Lopez got cheated on.
It doesn't matter. It's not just you. Everybody plays the fool at some point. But you have to realize that I'm better than this. Mm-hmm. I don't care if he do go find somebody else and she prettier than me and they happy off. Who cares? You have to think about you. Because eventually God will send you someone.
And brothers, you got to be the same way. I don't care if I got to pay child support.
Amen.
I don't care if I got to pay child support and get visitation rights. I'm not staying in this bad relationship.
Yeah, absolutely.
And sometimes, breakups cost.
Mm-hmm.
Breakup is going to, being in a toxic relationship, the breakup is going to cost you a lot of money. I will say that. Mm-hmm. But God will get you through it.
Yeah.
And God will. I'm done. Yeah, I think we kind of went over time today.
Yeah.
So we thank y'all for coming. But before we go, I like that. Amen. And must seek counsel from God first and wait for His instructions on what to do next. Also, Sister Walker, not only receive counsel from God, depending on the nature of the toxicity of the relationship, you may need to see counseling from a therapist.
Yeah.
We do prefer a professional, not the pastors all the time, but go see a professional if you've been in an abusive situation or no matter, I don't know what kind of situation you might have been in, but because you don't want to go into your next relationship with that toxicity.
Mm-hmm.
Okay. So, but we wanted to make sure, we don't assume everybody knows Jesus. We want to give you an opportunity to accept Jesus Christ as your Lord and Savior. The Bible says all you do is confess that Jesus Christ is Lord, believe God, raise him from the dead. Our Bible says,
you shall be saved.
You shall be saved. Maybe you don't have a church home. We would love for you to connect with us here at M.O.V.E. Church, Got to Move. We're doing some great things. This is where we are. This is who we are. Every day, actually. Every day, this is who we are, man. We're a little bit more sillier off screen. We try to be serious. We can, but, man, we just... this is who we are. We just believe in living life. Jesus said that he gave us life and gave us life more abundantly.
Yeah.
And we're enjoying our lives. And we want to help you get to the place where we are, not only spiritually, but emotionally, financially.
Yeah.
We want you to be healed. And I believe you can be healed at the M.O.V.E. Church. Finally, if you like to tithe, donate, or give to our ministry, you can do that at our Cash App at $GotToMOVE. $GotToMOVE or P.O. Box 2022, Culpeper, Virginia 22701. Sister Wong said, thank you both for teaching the talk today. God bless you and your household. Hey, God bless you too. And bless all of you that came. If I missed your name or whatever coming up, charge it to my head and my eyesight.
eyesight.
And Sister Mary, next Tuesday, I need you to get on time to hear my singing. You got on after the fact. So Mary, I need you to get on time. Or, I'm going to call you tomorrow and sing. That's what I'm going to do. No, I'm just playing. So, look, come out this Sunday, fifth Sunday, the Holiday Inn, 9:00. God has a word for you, but also come as we celebrate these high school graduates as they get ready to go to the next level of their life. Amen.
Amen.
So, we just want to celebrate them, give them, put a little something in their pocket. Amen. So, they can help go about their way. You got anything else, beautiful lady?
No.
Listen, I want to thank Ronnie Lynn for allowing us to use the Glam Cave and hanging out with me. By our executive pastor. She does great work. Love her to death. Love her to the moon and back. You my boo. Look at Mary. So, all right. Father God, Lord, we thank you.
Thank you.
Just for being awesome, Father. We ask you right now to continue to bless us. Father God, right now I pray for healing.
Yes.
For those who have been in bad relationships and been broken, Father God, I ask for healing and putting people back together, Father God, emotionally, spiritually, yes, financially. Father God, those who are living in the middle of a bad relationship, Father, I give you to give them strength that they find what your will is for their lives, Father.
Mm.
Father, I ask you to cover them while they're in that relationship that nothing around them will be destroyed,
yes,
or damaged permanently. Father, we know that you are a healer. Father God, we know you are a way maker. Father God, we know that you love us unconditionally, and we thank you for that.
Okay.
Father, we ask safety for all the ones who leave this connection with us tonight. In Jesus' name, amen.
Amen.
God bless you.
Thank you.
Love you all.